Here's the top 5 highest paying data jobs. As you know, data is listed as a top career. They say that companies that use data will thrive and the ones that don't won't. So what are these data jobs and what are the skills you need? As well as how much are these jobs getting paid? Today, I'll be going over these 3 questions based on my 43 pages of research, Glassdoor, and my personal experience as a BI engineer. Starting with the first job on the list, the US Bureau of Labor and Statistics estimates that this job will grow 23% through the year of 2032, and that is much higher than the average for all other occupations. And this job is a data analyst. What is a data analyst? Imagine you're a data analyst working at Amazon, and you're asked, how can we increase sales? A data analyst will look at the customer behavior, the trends of customer shopping, as well as what items are in the cart to then be able to make sense of all this data and make a recommendation so that the business can make data-driven decisions. So a data analyst will clean the data, analyze it, and present it. Skills used by a data analyst are a combination of hard and soft skills. For the hard skills, a data analyst should know Excel, SQL, ABI visualization tool, as well as some Python and statistics, and that really varies depending on the type of data analyst you are. And the type of soft skills that a data analyst will need include critical thinking, so the ability to analyze data, as well as communication. On Glassdoor, the average data analyst salary is around $82,000 and ranges to $126,000. Salary does really range by location, experience, as well as the industry. And I'll be doing a video on just data analyst salary. So please make sure you like this video and subscribe so that you do not miss it. The next job on the list is extremely similar to a data analyst, and that is a business intelligence engineer. That's what I do. So my workflow is the same as a data analyst. I will clean the data, analyze it, and present it. But also, I will work on the data collection piece, so building the data pipelines and figuring out the various data sources to pull for data analysis. The skills as well are really similar to a data analyst, but they will also be focused on data warehousing skills. So that includes using ETL tools as well as cloud computing and being able to model data. For the soft skills, a BI engineer will also need critical thinking and communication, but problem-solving skills will be key here because the nature of a business intelligence engineer is to work closely with the business to solve problems. The average salary of a BI engineer ranges from $131,000 to $155,000, and it is generally a higher salary than data analysts. And you may be thinking now, a BI engineer sounds really similar to a data engineer, which is the next on our list. So a data engineer does do a lot of the same activities of loading the data, collecting it, working with ETL tools, managing the data warehouse, but their focus is really on optimizing big data and organizing it for data analysis. Typically, the data engineers are less involved in the reporting and dashboarding like a BI engineer, and in the example of a data engineer who's working at Amazon to increase sales, their role would be to build out the data infrastructure and support all the analysis that the data analysts would need. In terms of skills, a data engineer will have stronger data warehousing skills than a BI engineer. They will also have stronger programming skills like Python and Java. And in the organization, their skill set does align closer to a software engineer because a data engineer's job is to focus more on the automation and using cloud technology. For soft skills, a data engineer will want to focus on attention to detail. This skill set is really important because their job is to focus on the quality of data. The data engineer salary is generally higher than a BI engineer, and that ranges from around $125,000, $169,000, and with the trend of big data, the data engineer role will be more in demand. We've been talking a lot about the back end of data, but what else can you do with data? And that gets us to data scientists. So data scientists are very similar to a data analyst role where they will be working on data analysis to get insights out of data, but the data scientists are more focused on using machine learning methods and techniques to be able to solve problems predicting the future. In terms of skills, the data scientist will have very similar skill sets as a data analyst, but they will have stronger statistics, math, as well as knowledge of machine learning. And they also will collect data, but they won't have as strong data warehousing skills as a data engineer. As for soft skills, critical thinking will be really important for data scientists because they have to systematically think about the different techniques and algorithms to use to solve a problem using data. The average salary of a data scientist is very high. It goes to $157,000 to $187,000. And I will say from my personal experience, I have seen data scientist salaries go past $300,000. And with the explosion of AI, the next job has increasingly become in demand, which is machine learning engineer. What is machine learning? It's the ability of machines to be able to predict an outcome based on data. So through algorithms, machine learning can identify trends and even make recommendations. A machine learning engineer is the person who builds and deploys these machine learning algorithms. So unlike a data scientist who sits closer to the business, a machine learning engineer is more focused on building the algorithms and deploying them into production. A machine learning engineer will have skill sets kind of similar to a data engineer and a data scientist. They're gonna know how to do cloud computing, work with big data, but also have really strong statistics skills as well as stronger machine learning skills and also some software engineering skills as well for their code. And as for soft skills, a machine learning engineer will need to have really strong problem skills because on the daily, they're going to be faced with really ambiguous and complex problems that they need to solve by creating a learning model. The average salary of a machine learning engineer is very high. It's around $126,000, ranging to $188,000, and it is one of the higher ones on the list today. And to put it all together, you can see the different strengths of all the data roles that I talked about today, but you can also see that there is a lot of overlap between all of them. And so when you're looking for a job in the data industry, you really want to look at the job description and less on the title because that will determine how much you should get paid. Let me know in the comments which of these data roles you're interested in because I do read every single one of them. And if you want to learn more about a fundamental data skill, which is SQL, I go over a SQL interview question in the next video. And thank you so much. I will see you there.